All right. Jared, coach usually gives us a few comments on what transpired and so forth.
Yeah. If that game there doesn't prove that we're one of the best 15, 10 teams in the state of Maryland, then I don't know what else we got to do. We didn't play our best game and still had a chance at the end of the basketball game. You got to get those key moments to happen in the game. We had a couple of them. Kudos to Edmondson. They played hard and they hit a couple of huge threes when they got us out of sorts on defense on just a few possessions. I mean, defensively, I don't think we could play much better. Just we let a lot of some middle drives there. They got some kick out threes and were daggers that made them. So, we're really proud of
them. Right. I've seen a couple things you guys did. They were getting multiple chances, especially in the first half, but they weren't capitalizing on them because luckily those long bombs they kept throwing back up, they weren't going in.
Yep.
And then the pressure they put on you didn't seem to, it didn't shut you guys down or bother you that much. It seemed to, as we unfortunately saw, the very last, let's call it minute, let's say.
Yeah, I think that's basketball, right? I mean, at the end of the basketball game, you get maybe a different look. They ran a fake man-to-man to get back into the same press that they've been running all game and all year long. The kids didn't recognize it on one possession, which allowed them to get, a really key possession there. And then when we adjusted to it, I don't think it was any issue except for right at the end, we're trying to force the ball to the floor. So I don't get it. That one's not the same thing. It was just that one possession. The kids didn't recognize that they were in a faux pressure there, which kudos to them. They confused the kids up front a little bit. And just that one possession is really it's all that was the game.
Well, just talk about what you guys accomplished. I don't think a lot of people picture you guys being not only here in the state semifinals, but be within a possession of getting to the state final. And then you both can answer that question.
Yeah, I mean, all season we were talked about how we were in the lower division over up back. We talked about how we shouldn't be here, but every team thought we weren't that great. We improved, we won big games, we beat a good Aberdeen team who won the upper division in our age group. We won a close regional championship game. The game after that was a nice one-point game. Teams were just didn't think we were that good, but we were that good.
Yeah, talk about that, coach. Just kind of use it. I'm sure you used that as motivation throughout the, especially, I guess, from mid-season on.
Yeah, I mean, our culture, we talk about our culture all year long. I mean, this is not our first rodeo down here. This is our third time since I've been coaching there in 12 years. So this is not new to our program, but these guys just believed they had a higher belief. And I think you go through the season, you wonder how good you are. You wonder, you're beating people by 30, by 40. You wonder how good you are, and then you play an Aberdeen team and beat them, who won the upper division and supposedly is supposed to be the best up in Harford County. Well, they weren't, we were. And then you get to a scenario where you get into playoffs and you gotta grind it out. And then you play, an Edmondson team by the Baltimore Sun, I guess it's 12 or 13 or something like that. I can't distinguish them from us. So I think, the culture that we have at Patterson Mill is beautiful. The kids love each other. You can see by the emotion of these kids next to me. Try not to look over at them. This was just another one of the special teams that we had at Patterson Mill, and I miss the boys dearly.
Coach, as you mentioned, you've been here a couple of times. I know with CJ, you were here once or twice.
Yeah, yeah.
But talk to me about the difference of going to Maryland and coming here. Was it harder to get up for a game when you're not going to the University of Maryland with the bright lights and the big stadium? Talk to me about that.
That's a good question. I don't think so. I mean, for us, every game's the biggest game of the year. You hear me say big day, it's a chance to get better every day that we're in the gymnasium. So I don't think that affects us too much at all, really. But I tell you what, this is a much different environment. If I was anybody making the rules, there's no way I'd be back here again. I'd go to College Park for the semifinals every single time. It's like you said, there's just something to it. It's just lovely. Did it change the game? I don't think so at all.
Quick question for Tyree. I know you're a senior. Could you just summarize your career here at Patterson Mill?
Nobody even thought I would be finishing high school. I went to too much, dropped out and came back, and nobody really thought they was, oh, he's going to be somebody in the streets. But I'm here right now, and there's people looking at me to play basketball, and I'm going to play basketball, and I just want to prove everybody wrong. And tonight was a chance to do that, and we fell short at the end.
Which I'm not sure if anyone asked this. I came in a bit late, but it seemed like you guys had a lot of turnovers tonight. Was there something defensively, schematically that they did, or have you guys been facing turnover issues all year?
No, not at all. Edmondson's good, man.
Yeah,
they don't play like a regular defense today. Actually, all the games that I scouted, this is probably the more base set defense that they ran. But they try to trap you, they try to pressure you the entire basketball game and get you up and down and get you out of your sorts. So kudos to them. It was more so them than it was, anything that we've done all year, averaging like, between 12, 13 turnovers a game, somewhere between there. So, yeah, no, they're just good.
I know it's tough to lose the last game, Coach, but again, just talk about this journey with these young men, especially not after not having a season last year. But did you have a season? I don't know. Maybe you did.
Choked up a little bit, I think. Man. I mean, love those guys. They came into practice like you wouldn't believe every day. Everything they got, every minute that we're out there. We don't have. He's going to school for going on scholarship for lacrosse. Like he said, he's coming back off of. Extraordinary circumstance. I couldn't be more proud of him. We got our point guard number four is a soccer guy, lacrosse guy that's played basketball his whole life, and just going out there and giving everything he's got. And obviously you got Kyle, who's had an amazing year with I think 9 or 10 30-point games this year. So he's going to go play college ball. But you got Drew Pape, sophomore. I'm throwing him out there to the Wolves against Edmondson, 6'4" sophomore point guard who. Golly, he's got a bright future, so he's a dog, yeah. And then the guys on the bench just coming in here. I mean, we got this kid, Fletcher Steinkraus, who has barely played all year. Yesterday, we're getting ready to leave. He reminds us about a scout situation that we missed in practice. He's like, Coach, you want to work on their double high? You saw him run it like multiple times today, that little horn stagger set up top. I'm looking like, gee, can we get 6 more practices, 7? Yeah, so to me, just speaks to our culture, speaks to the kids. I don't want to go look at those guys here in a few seconds.
Good? Hey, great season, guys. Appreciate your time.